In this video, you will learn about a commonly used method to evaluate the accuracy of a classification model called the Receiver Operating Characteristic, ROC Curve. Ready? Let's dive in.
The ROC Curve shows the quality and robustness of the classification model as defined by the false positive rate and the true positive rate, or in other words, sensitivity and 1 minus specificity. Many scoring metrics measure the performance of a classification model for only one specific value of the threshold applied to the probability of the positive class. However, this is just one possible working point for the classification model. The ROC curve attempts to provide a more comprehensive view of the model's performance for different classification thresholds. Here you see the ROC curve. On the x-axis, you see the false positive rate, and on the y-axis, the true positive rate. This blue line is the ROC curve of the trained model, and the black line is the ROC curve of a random classifier. For each input event, a classification model produces a class probability that determines the class assignment. By default, events are assigned to the positive class if the probability of the positive class is 0.5 or higher, and to the negative class otherwise. If you increase this classification threshold, fewer data points will be assigned to the positive class. If you decrease the threshold, more events will be assigned to the positive class. Here you see a number of events ordered by their probabilities to belong to the positive class. By default, the value of the classification threshold is set to 0.5. And here are the corresponding assignments to the two classes. Next, decrease the threshold value, for example, to 0.2. Now you see that the class assignment changes for the data points with the probability for the positive class falling between 0.2 and 0.5. Finally, let's increase the classification threshold to 0.7. Now only those events with a probability for the positive class greater than 0.7 will be assigned to the positive class. As you can see, the true positive rate and the false positive rate also change every time you change the threshold value. The true positive rate is calculated as the number of correct predictions for the positive class divided by the total number of events in the positive class. The false positive rate is calculated as the number of incorrect predictions for the positive class divided by the total number of events in the negative class. For these threshold values, let's plot the false positive rates on the x-axis and the true positive rates on the y-axis. This dot represents the performance of the model for the default threshold. This dot stands for the threshold of 0.2, and this is for the threshold 0.7. Connecting these dots give us a sketch of the ROC curve. In reality, the ROC curve is drawn based on many more threshold values, and therefore many more pairs of these two rates. The ROC curve of a perfect classifier will move along the axis to reach the point where the true positive rate is 1 and the false positive rate is 0. The closer the curve of our model is to that point, the better the model is performing. For a random classifier in a two-class problem, all events have the same probability for the positive class, independently of their actual class values. By varying the classification threshold, the ROC curve becomes a straight line. This is the worst performance your model can produce. If the ROC curve of your model lies below the line of the random classifier, then you probably made a mistake in building the ROC curve. The ROC curve has several advantages as a model evaluation technique. Firstly, it allows you to visually compare different models in terms of performance. If you have more than one model, the model with the highest ROC curve will be the best performing one. Secondly, if visual comparison among model curves becomes complicated, you can always use the area under the curve, AUC measure. The AUC measures the area under the ROC curve and ranges from 1 for a perfect classifier to 0.5 for a random classifier. Thirdly, the ROC curve allows us to choose the threshold that produces the best performance. One method to select the optimal threshold is to minimize the Euclidean distance between the curve and the point on the top left corner, indicating perfect model performance. The point in the curve that minimizes this distance is the tangent point shown here.
In this video, you have learned how an ROC curve is drawn given the actual class values, probabilities of the positive class, false positive rate, the true positive rate, and classification thresholds. You have also learned about the robustness of the ROC curve as a method to quantify and compare model performances.